Dear Rose, we have come to the end of the role play. Now we'll continue with the oral question number two. So how do you find your role play?
I think it's okay.
It's okay, good. Alright, actually your role play you have done very well. So we can continue with this oral question. Are you ready?
Yes.
Why is it important to serve, greet, and bid farewell to customers?
To portray professional image for the organization.
Then how do you find out what the customer needs?
By asking open-ended questions.
Very good. Next is, when a customer objects to the price of an item, claiming that other stores are selling it cheaper, what will you say?
I will highlight the key features of the product and the store policy of giving more years of warranty, and highlight other non-price features that might address customers' concern on price objection.
Okay, good. And how do you match customers' requirement to your product recommendation?
On customer preferred color, design, material mentioned by the customer.
Okay. Come to the last question, and that will be, name one reason why you may need to present alternative product to the customer.
I don't think that's in the SOP. I don't think this question, I mean, this is not stated in the SOP.
Are you very sure about that?
I don't remember having to present any of this alternative product to customer.
Maybe you'll take some time to just run through this. You can confirm this.
It's not stated in the SOP.
Okay, so you're very sure. That's actually the last question. Like I said, your role play you've done very well. Your oral questioning, you've done, in fact, you've answered most of the questions except the last one. But as with WSQ requirement, all questions have to be answered. Since you cannot answer the last question, I have to assess you as not yet competent.
But that is so unfair. I mean, if I have 90% right and just one that is not right, I think that's very unfair that I'm not competent in this area.
Yeah, but for the WSQ, you just have to have 100% pass for this all the questions. But since one of them is not correct, we have to certify you as not yet competent. Because in this standard operation procedure, the one requirement of a candidate is to be familiar with the organization's procedure, and it's on page 2. It is on page 2. So it's actually in there, you can see. It's actually.
Okay.
You're supposed to be familiar. Do you agree that I can mark you as NYC? If so, then I think here, can you sign over here?
I don't agree, but I will sign.
Yeah, okay, so you have a right to appeal. You have a right to appeal. And let me just go through with you the right to appeal procedures. You have to submit within 7 days of this assessment, and you have to pay $30. Okay, and if you are okay with that, can you just sign here. I just don't care. Then you sign here. Okay, not to worry. It's just that one part that you're not familiar with. And when you go to this last part here, the next time around, when you get accessed again, you can be competent with that area. Okay, so you do have any feedback for me? As an assessor?
No, I do not have any feedback.
Okay, so then in that case, can I introduce you, let me do some recording?
Yes.
Okay, so that'll be all. And this is the appeal form that you can use if you need to appeal.
You need 7 days, right?
Yeah. It's okay. You're okay with that? And that's it. That's all.
Thank you.
Just try to.